Welcome to Fragrance Facts, where I give you truthful and tested details on a fragrance so you can learn more about it. My name is Marcus, and this is my review on Guerlain's Épices Volées from the Or et la Matière collection. This is a 2021 release, classified as a woody chypre. It's composed by Jean-Paul Guerlain, and it's an eau de parfum concentration. So this here is a sample of the fragrance Épices Volées, and the translation in English is Stolen Spices. Now this fragrance line, L'Or et la Matière, I made a video on to explain the vast changes within the collection. Check out that video for more detail. And I did mention Épices Volées in that video, and that this new version is replacing Lupin, or Arsène Lupin Le Voyou, which was a 2010 release. Now the scents here are similar, and I will tell you if there are differences later on. And we're gonna kick off with the top and how this fragrance smells. So in the top, what you get is this coriander, sage, artemisia herbs with a citrus and light cardamom clove spices. It will be herbal, lightly spicy, and lightly clean, powdery sweet. That light, clean, powdery sweetness reminds me of the way that artemisia is used in Jean-Paul Gaultier's La Mole. In the mid, you have very light clove cardamom spices, a clean herbal artemisia sage, and a vanillic resinous benzoin. It will be light, spicy, herbal, resinous, vanilla. And in the base, it will be this light, smoky, patchouli earthiness with a vanilla, creamy sandalwood. It will be smoky, earthy, creamy, vanilla. Let's discuss the performance for Épices Volées. We're talking an arm's length projection for about an hour and a half, and then it gets closer to the skin. It's a skin scent at 4 hours, and I was able to detect it off my skin up to 13 hours. The Sillage scent whiff trail was a moderately detectable bubble around me for 2 hours, and then it got lower, and there's times where you think this fragrance is totally gone, but once in a while it will linger back and pop up, and I was able to detect this up to 6 hours of total sillage. So this will be between average to below average in the performance category. And even if there is the note of clove here, it's done very lightly. The spices here are done very lightly. So if you're interested in trying a fragrance with the note of clove, but are afraid that it's too powering and it's too strong for you, this would be the perfect introductory clove scent because it's super tame and light in this composition. The scent profile DNA of this is gonna remind you of that classic masculine barbershop gentleman scent, axed around this light, spicy, herbal, and vanilla smell. It's gonna remind you a bit of fragrances on the market, kind of like Parfums de Marly, Darly. So the way that the herbs are done, the vanilla, and that barbershop kind of a vibe in Darly. And you're also gonna have some bits and pieces that will remind you as well of something like Gravitas Porum by Naughton and Wilson. And you're also gonna have that artemisia, vanilla, and style of a smell that will also remind you of Jean-Paul Gaultier's La Mole at certain stages. So you have all kinds of different smells here that are different. You got lighter designer releases, you got middle class prices like Gravitas, and you have the higher expensive Parfums de Marly. So if you do find Épices Volées too expensive and you want a fragrance that's similar to this one, look into the other ones that I just showed you. It's gonna give you a similar vibe without this being an exact identical clone. I did get some compliments with Épices Volées, but not too much. I only got people saying that it was a pleasant and nice smelling fragrance, between 7 to 7.5 ratings out of 10. But I got personally better success with the other fragrances that I've shown you. This one is gonna be very user friendly. It's gonna have light spices. So if you're not a fan of clove, this one could be a good one. It also has this classic old school kind of a vibe to it as well. And I have smelled Lupin or Arsène Lupin Le Voyou in the past, and it does smell similar to this one, but that one does have a bit more performance. It does last a bit longer, so this one is a bit watered down compared to that one, but the smells is pretty much the same. So you don't need to go out of your way to spend lots of money for that one. You can just get this one, but this one actually is pretty expensive too. So maybe if you do shop it around, you might find Lupin cheaper, because these new Henri Lamatière are pretty expensive because they did increase the prices. So hopefully this fragrance review gave you information that can help you understand this scent better. See you in the next one. Take care. Peace and lights out.